Good morning, everyone. So it's your English class, and today we are going to study our first chapter of second unit, that is recreative reuse. So recreative reuse means to use the wasting for a different purpose or for a new purpose, right? Basically for home decoration. So in this chapter, we will understand how to use the waste things. And in this chapter, we will also understand how to make a mask. Basically, that is called papier mâché. That's the name of this papier mâché. That's the name of a particular mask. So papier mâché, we will understand how to make this. Okay, so let's start. Look at these pictures. So you need to see these, all the pictures. Identify what has been used creatively to make these items. So these items have been used with the waste things, means which things are not useful. So these things have made with the waste things. You need to identify which waste things have been used in these items. Okay. Now let's understand the chapter line by line. There is a growing community out there waking up to the challenges of our time and finally realizing that we live on a planet with finite resources, rediscovering the old virtues of swapping, mending, giving a new life to something old, turning trash into treasure. So basically, in this paragraph, author wants to say that there is a growing community, and that is very well aware regarding the challenges of present time, and they have realized that resources of on this planet are finite. Finite means like which is limited, which is not in full quantity. So resources are finite, and we need to rediscover the things, and we need to mend the things, we need to swap the things, and by using the trash things, we need to make them treasure, means we need to alter the things. Next line, creative reuse, also known as upcycling or repurposing, is the process of taking material or products that are unwanted for their original function, and through creativity, transforming them into pieces of art and home decoration or other useful items. So author says that in these lines, so we need to use the recreative reuse, and recreative reuse is also known upcycling and repurposing, right? So I tell you what is the recreative reuse, like to use the waste thing for basically home decoration, that is called recreative reuse, right? And suppose like you have an old cycle and that is not working, and you use that old cycle for decoration and for different purpose. So that is called recreative reuse of that cycle, right? And this recreative reuse is also called upcycling or repurposing, right? Next line, this is different from recycling, where products are broken down to their component parts and remanufactured into new products. So in this, author says that recycling is something else. Recycling and recreative reuse are not same. Why? Because in recreative reuse, we use the waste thing for different purpose, basically for home decoration and for art. But in recycling, we break the product in the components and we remanufacture that product. Okay, suppose you have a same old cycle and you break it and you make something else. After breaking it means you manufacture something else. Okay, so that is called recycling, not recreative reuse. Okay. Next, recreative reuse is also different from conventional reuse. Conventional reuse means general reuse, like whatever we use for any things for a common purpose, that is called conventional reuse, right? Where the product is used in its original purpose again, So conventional reuse means like same item you need to take, like suppose you have an old cycle and you like cycle is not working and you put some parts in that cycle and again you make that working cycle, that is called conventional reuse. Means you use the old things, waste thing for the same purpose, you make the same thing, that is called conventional reuse, right? Next, creative reuse is not about doom and gloom. So doom and gloom means such a situation like a bad and unhappy situation, that is called doom and gloom. So creative reuse is not about doom and gloom. It is process of transforming byproducts, waste material, useless and unwanted products into new materials or products of better quality or better environmental value. So in recreative reuse, we use the old things, we use the waste things, and we make a new product which is better than the previous and it is environmental free. Means like we can't harm the environment with those new things. Next, products using everyday waste material allow the user to take part in their construction and invite them simply and creatively experience the concept of sustainability. So sustainability means such an idea like in which we manufacture new things, but those new things are not harmful for the environment, right? So by this, we get the experience of using new things creatively and simple method, and that is sustainability. Means like that is the not harmful for the environment. Next line. The addition of creativity to an already manufactured item has a new function. So by this second benefit is that when we reuse the things like creative reuse, we do that. So what is the original purpose? Along with this, we get a second purpose also of that thing. Like some examples are written here. For example, a CD case can become a bird feeder. Bottle corks can be used to make a cork board and t-shirt can be transformed into a rug. So author wants to say to us like CD case, you know that. So with the recreative reuse, we can use the CD case for a different purpose also. CD case we can use for CDs also. Along with this, with the recreative reuse, we can make a bird feeder, right? And with the bottle cork means like a lid of the like a wooden lid of any bottle. So by this, we can make a cork board and we can hang something on this. We can paste, we can pin up something. Any notice there? And with the old t-shirt, we can make rug means like a such a cloth. By this, we use for mopping, right? So this is the second benefit of recreative reuse. Next, papier-mâché. So about this, we are going to understand how to make papier-mâché. Firstly, we will understand what is papier-mâché. Then we will understand how to make the papier-mâché. So papier-mâché, pronounced papier-mâché, is the perfect environmentally friendly craft and can be picked up easily by an enthusiast. Enthusiast means such a person who is quite interested to do anything, who is quite interested by himself or herself to do anything. That is called enthusiast. So papier-mâché is totally environmental friendly. So anyone can make it with the happiness. It is an excellent hobby for people who like to work with their hands. So with the hands we can make it, and it's a very good activity. Papier-mâché in French means chewed paper. So the like this is a French word, and in French it meaning is that chewed paper, right? Paper which has been chewed, that is called papier-mâché. It involves using shredded or torn paper. Shredded means like which paper has been cut or torn. So in this we use like a torn paper or shredded paper and paste to construct sturdy, lightweight articles of any size or shape. So by this we can make item which can be very lightweight and very sturdy, very strong, and any size and any shape we can make with the papier mache. Right? Actually, papier mache is a mixture of something. So, and we will make mask with the papier mache, and then I will understand how to make a mask with the papier mache. Okay. What is astonishing about papier mache is the way old paper that. Okay, so dear students, we have studied first chapter, means like first page we have studied here. So on the behalf of first page, I want to put some question. I want to ask some question. So get ready for this. You need to raise your hand and I want to see that. Have you understood the first page of this chapter note? Okay, so some question, some internal question I'm going to put. So get ready for this. My first question is that you can raise your hand. Recreative reuse is also known as. So I'm telling you, recreative reuse is also known as. So you need to tell the second and third name of recreative reuse. So that's not recreative, that's a creative reuse. So rewritten by mistake. So that is a creative reuse, right? Not recreative. Re was written by mistake. So raise your hand who can let me know, who can give me the answer of our first question on the behalf of first page understanding. Mansi, can you tell me?
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, Mansi.
Sir. Sir, creative reuse is also known as upcycling.
Upcycling
and two names you described.
Yeah, repurposing. So two names are there. Very good, right answer. So recycling and repurposing, we can say creative reuse, right? Good, very good. You have given the right answer. So second question is that. Is recycling different to recreative? You need to say either yes or no. Again, I describe my question. Is recycling different to recreative? Who will let me know? Raise your hand if you know the answer. Please wait. Let me do some setting. Let me extend the size of this box so that I can see the hand of everyone. Please stay connected. Yes, Sanchi Bhatia, you please tell me. You have to reply in either in yes or no. Sanchi, please tell me.
Sir, वहाँ question में recreative है या creative है?
By mistake, that's a return. That's a creative, not recreative. It's a typing mistake.
Okay,
so
sir.
Is recycling different to creative reuse?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Yes, that's a different, because in recycling we do something else, and creative reuse we do something else. Very good, right answer. So after just giving the answer, I request all the students please go in the mute mode. Next, we can make a bird feeder with. I describe one thing. One name was described, and by this we can make a bird feeder. So what was that? Who will let me know? Khushi, you please tell me. Khushi, can you tell me?
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, Khushi.
Sir, we can make a bird feeder with CD.
With CD case. Very good. Approximate right answer you have given. Good beta. With CD case, we can make a bird feeder. Very good, right answer. Next question. In language, papier mache is called chewed paper. So you need to tell me the language name. In which language we can say that papier mache is called chewed paper. So language name you have to let me know. So who will tell me? Let me see. Sneha, you please tell me.
French.
Yes, in French language, The meaning of papier-mâché is chewed paper. Very good, right answer you have given. French language. So now, in this way, I can ask some internal questions. So please pay the heed whenever I teach you any chapter. Right? So now you can down your hand because next page I'm going to describe. Please down your hand. So in the last line, it was written, what is astonishing about papier-mâché is the way old paper, that rather filmy stuff, can be transformed through a process of mixture with paste into extremely hard and durable objects. So same thing as I described you earlier. So in this, we use the paper and we make a paste, and with this, we make a hard and durable objects. And how to make? And this will be described in the coming pages. The origin of papier-mâché dates back to ancient China. So origin of this papier-mâché is ancient China. Means China started this. One of the earliest known use of papier-mâché was among ancient Egyptians. So ancient Egyptian also used the papier-mâché, who used it to craft masks used in death ceremonies. So in the death ceremonies, they used to use this mixture, this papier-mâché. Papier-mâché is a mixture of glue, water, and old paper. So they used to use this mixture for death ceremonies, for basically for making the masks. The French popularized this modulable pulp in Europe during 16th century. So French people also made it famous in the Europe during 16th century. Next line. Here is a procedure for making a papier-mâché mask. Use these steps by step-by-step directions and discover how easy it is to create amazing papier-mâché work of art. So dear students, in this incoming lines, incoming paragraphs, so process of making masks will be described with the help of papier-mâché, right? So you need to understand, and you should try to make the make such type of mask at your home. Okay, after using the papier-mâché, I will describe also how to make the papier-mâché. Next, this activity has been suggested by Johnny Good. So Johnny Good was a person and who was a leading sculptor. So he was a leading sculptor and his name was Johnny Good. He suggested this activity. So this striking orangutan mask can be used as a wall hanging or a school dramatic production. Let me come on the next page, next slide. Okay. So in this, like dear students, we have to understand there is a monkey that is called ape. That is the Indonesian monkey that his name is orangutan mask. So we have to give the shape of orangutan. Orangutan is a monkey that you can see, that's the ape, that's a monkey of the Indonesia. So this shape we have to make, means this type of mask we have to make with the help of that mixture, right? And that mask you can hang in the in the school wall or any dramatic productions, you can use that mask. The orangutan is an endangered great ape native to Indonesia. So that is related to Indonesia and that is endangered, right? So materials required. So these are the materials which are required to make the mask of orangutan. Materials are cardboard. You need to use cardboard, glue, sticky tape, which is used to stick something, sandpaper. And next is varnish. Varnish is such a chemical. By this, we can use those varnish on any paint and it maintains the finishing of that paint. That's called varnish. Newspaper, you have to use. Water, you have to use. And brown paper also you have to use. And acrylic paint, which the paint is used for like painting, that's called acrylic paint, and wooden and woolen yarn. Woolen yarn means like woolen thread you have to use with this. Okay, these are the materials you have to use, right? So orangutan mask we are going to make. Let me come back on the last page. Yes, step one. So now we will understand how to make the orangutan mask with the help of papier mache. Step one, start by cutting out a piece of scrap cardboard in the basic shape of the orangutan face. So firstly, you need to take a cardboard. You need to cut the shape of orangutan face, right? Then add some crumpled pieces of newspaper, held the mask tape to form its muzzle, cheeks and forehead. So you need to use some crumpled pieces of paper, means stressed paper you have to use, and by the tape you need to make muzzle. Muzzle means like a face of like any dog. So such type of face you have to make, cheeks you have to make, and forehead you have to make by using the pieces of like a crumpled pieces of newspaper and with the sticking tape. This is the first step. Second step, continue molding the underlying base for the mask for forming a long thin roll of paper to shape the eyes socket, and you may add a small bump for nose. So for small bump also you can add, just for making the nose, and you can make a thin roll paper and you can shape the eyes like you can see here. So by this you can add, you can make the eyebrow, and nose you can add the crumpled paper and you can make the nose. Okay, so in this way you have to make, right? Next, so our second page is completed. So again I want to put some question on the behalf of understanding of second page. So our first question is that who suggested this activity, means of making the mask of a monkey. So we are going to make, so who suggested this activity? Who will let me know? Okay, Mansi, you please, let me ask from another student. Yes, Sneha, you tell me please, who suggested this activity? Name was
the activity has been suggested by Johnny Good.
Yes, Johnny Good suggested this activity. Very good, right answer. Very good, beta. Next question. Oh, which ape means monkey mask are we trying to learn? So you need to tell the name of the monkey. Okay, monkey means ape. So the name was described in this. So who will let me know? Let me ask from Mihika. Mihika, you please tell me. Mihika and Megan, please tell me that monkey name, that ape name. Okay, I think she doesn't want to give the answer. Mannat, you please good tell morning. Me. Okay, good morning, Mihika. Who is there, Mihika or Megan? Okay, Kanishka, you please tell me. What's that monkey name of which face mask we are going to make? Okay, I think it's a little difficult to learn that name. So that is orangutan. Orangutan, that is the monkey orangutan, right? So of this monkey face mask we are going to learn, we are going to make, right? Next. Where are orangutan found? So in which country these type of monkeys, orangutan monkeys, are found? That country name was described when I was describing the second page. So who will let me know? Mannat, can you tell me? Mannat, can you tell me?
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Can you tell me country name?
Sir, in Indonesia.
in Indonesia. Very good, right answer. Good. So that country name is Indonesia. Like there, such type of monkeys, like orangutan monkeys, are found there. Very good, right answer. So, dear students, again I tell you, in this way I can ask you question regarding the pages, regarding the chapter. These will be internal questions, so please pay the heed when I describe any chapter, any page, okay? So that I can test you are studying, you are paying heed or not, you are listening to me or not. Okay, come on the next page. So now, step three. Now fill an above eye socket with more paper, build up the lips with two pieces of crumpled paper and add the eyeballs. Also fill in the cheekbones a bit and work all around to give it face you want. So what type of face, like shape you want to give, you can give, you can make the eye socket, means eye socket is mean like hole of eyes you can make, and lips you can make with two pieces of crumpled paper, and eyeball also you can make. Also you can fill the cheekbones, like here also you can fill that crumpled paper. Okay, so in this way you can give the shape, right? Step four, completely cover the paper with sticky tape. After making the shape with the crumpled means crush karke paper jo hote hain, aap paper ko haath mein pakad ke crush kar dete hain, that is called crumpled. So completely cover the paper with sticky tape. After that, after using that crumpled paper, then you have to use sticky tape on that. Okay, the papier mache then will not stick to it very well, and you might be able to remove from when the skin is dry. So we need to add completely tape on that. Why? Because this is the shape. On this we will make the mask and we will remove this base. This is the base, we can say that. Okay, when mask will be ready, so tape will be used as we use a cello tape. So that will not help to stick that mask with this base, and we can remove that mask with this base. Okay, so here we have to use sticky tape. Next line. Step five. Once the orangutan face shape is ready, prepare the papier mache paste by mixing about one part of water and two parts of glue. So after shape is ready, face is ready, then you have to make now papier mache paste, and in this you can add one part water and two part glue, means gum you can add in this, right? That is the mixture of water and glue. Next, the newspaper is turned.